Hi, Cancer. It's Sloane Rhodes here with your love and romance reading for mid-January, roughly into mid-February, into the end of February 2017. And we drawing three cards from the Fairy Tarot. Look at the general energies for you during this time period, Cancer. Three cards from the Romance Angels Oracle deck and one card from the Tarot of Sexual Magic in the area of physical and sexual intimacy. I have already shuffled all the decks, Cancer, but I'm just going to shuffle again as I tune into your energies. And we'll go ahead and get started with your reading. Cancer, water sign. Okay, nope. Ten of Winter popped right out. Okay. The Dreamer, beautiful Major Arcana energy, and the Nine of Spring. Very interesting. And there's that Princess of Winter. Okay, so we have Cancer, we have the Ten of Winter, we have the Dreamer, and we have the Nine of Spring. What I love to see about these two together is that we have this ending of something and then a brand new beginning. And then you kind of like defending the work that you've done and this place that you're at in a lot of different ways. That Major Arcana energy, the Dreamer energy right in the center, that leap of faith, brand new beginning. So you have been, you in love, Cancer, maybe you're ending a difficult time between you and your partner, or even if you are single, a period of difficulty is ending and you're beginning a brand new beginning. But as you begin your brand new beginning, you're looking backwards very much at where you've been. Like, it's almost like, and if you haven't ended yet, you're approaching the end of this cycle, the culmination of difficulties tipping over into this new beginning. But look how they're both looking at each other. So I feel like for many of you Cancers, they're still very tightly together. Like, it's the beginning and the end are kind of as one, as I feel it for you, as well as this idea of you're starting this brand new beginning, and you're really kind of looking backwards to where you've come and looking down into this valley and making sure that where you are is actually where you want to be. And it's almost like you can't believe that you're starting fresh in some ways. It's like you're like, wow, did I make it? Did I really do it? Am I really here? It's that kind of energy. I really... There's even when I was shuffling, there's a sense of sort of joy as I felt it for you. Like you're kind of like, yes, I made it. And I don't want to go back there. It's kind of how I'm feeling it. And even if you haven't tilted into this energy yet, Cancer, it looks like you're going to. I'm really feeling the sunlight coming through, like the sun's breaking through the clouds and illuminating you here on this brand new journey. And then we had this Nine of Spring, which is like, yes, let me defend. Because everything's kind of looking back towards this Ten of Winter, like not wanting to almost like you can't believe it's ending in some ways. Like you want to prepare, like you know you're on a new journey, but you want to prepare and make sure that you've learned all the lessons from before. It's kind of feels like for me. And then we have this Princess of Winter under the deck, kind of an underlying or emerging energy of maybe information coming in that's not so easy to hear, but that's really helpful to you, or even a new consciousness that you are beginning to understand more deeply around yourself and love, or around your love situation. But we also have the Nine of Summer under that, which is the dreams kind of coming true, coming to fruition in a lot of different ways. So let me go ahead and get three cards from the Romance Angels deck. With that Nine of Summer, it's almost like it's because we had the Nine of Spring, and I'm seeing this Nine of Summer also under the deck for you, so it's drawing my attention, Cancer. I wanted to say that with those two nines there, it's almost like a pause before you continue. Like, I think this is why they're looking towards this as I see it. It's like, yeah, this is ending, and you're ready to get going, and you're ready to take that leap of faith, but it's almost like there's like a little bit of a pause before you hit the gas, is how it feels. And what that means for you is going to be different for everybody because it's a general reading. But it's an energy that's present in your love life right now. But I'll get more information as we go along. Romantic feelings, release your ex, retreat. I do want to say this, there's a slight chance that this could be an air sign, a kind of a younger feeling air sign who is at play here. But it's not an individual, just maybe an energy. But let me get, okay, I'll show you the cards as I see them. We have the romantic feelings card, we have the release your ex card, and we have the retreat card here. Your feelings are real and worth exploring. The time has come to clear your energy, and it's time to disconnect from the world. Let me get one more card from the Tarot of Sexual Magic for you, Cancer. Beautiful card. Again, the culmination, the ending of something, the fullness of something coming to fruition for you, and then the dreamer. You know, it's like it's all present for you, this idea of endings and new beginnings kind of coming together. And it's almost like you're like putting a kind of a pause on it to go, wait, have I integrated all the lessons? Is this where I want to go? Kind of energy here. But let's take a look at this Ten of Winter here. Well, let's take a look at all of it, really, as I feel it for you. So with the idea, it's really interesting because if we look down the midline here, we have the dreamer, we have the release your ex, and then we have the world, right? So this new beginning, this idea of release, and then the everything coming to its conclusion, right? So we could even look at it in reverse in terms of your physical intimacy. You know, the ending of something, that the culmination of this area of either being single, being alone in love, or this idea of the end of a union, of releasing your ex. But if it's not an actual individual whose energy you are releasing, it's you releasing, well, first of all, it could be an actual person, but if it's not the person and it's not their energy, it's about you releasing the pattern of how you connected to that person that wasn't as you know yourself to be today, right? Because we have this brand new beginning, as you are today. Not last week, not a month ago, but today. Okay. And then we have that retreat. It's time to disconnect from the world. For some of you, that may be that you go off with someone on a nice retreat, or it could just be you wanting some time alone as we go forward here. But let me get some additional cards for you. Cancer, on this Ten of Winter, find out what that's about. And also this Dreamer. Five of Autumn, Six of Spring. Okay, 1 second here, Cancer. This Dreamer, what's this about? Of Autumn, Prince of Autumn. Interesting. Eight of Summer. Okay. So Cancer. So there, we have this 10 of winter, right? A bad ending to a bad situation, end of codependencies, addictions, the end of a cycle of difficulty, right? And it's about, for many of you, about either a marriage or a relationship that has just been kind of limping along, I want to say. But then we have, ultimately, we have victory. We have this idea of you being in the spotlight of this kind of area of a sense of success, victory. It could be that you get married, and that is the period of that's ending here, of being alone, right? Difficulties in that area. Finally getting with this person, you know, and then yes, victory. And then for some of you, it might be the end of that actual connection, and then kind of the sense of like, yes, you know, I've done it. But for some of you, I kind of feel like it could also be actually getting together and taking your relationship public. And then we have this dreamer energy, this brand new beginning. Embrace your true purpose, begin a new adventure, trust yourself is the text on this card for this deck. And it's a leap of faith, really, truly, brand new beginning. It's about the six of autumn, which is considered in some cases like the good karma card. Like it's about, you know, the good that you've been doing, the good work you've been doing, coming back to fruition, coming into fruition, you know, coming back to roost, or that kind of expression. And it could be that there is an earth sign involved here, Virgo, Taurus, or Capricorn, and Sun, Moon, Rising. And with that brand new beginning, you're wanting more reciprocity, you're wanting more of this kind of sense of equality, and it could be either about this earth sign, or it could just be that this has been a long time coming. If it's not an earth sign, it could just be an individual who's been very slow moving here, and it could be that that person is the person you're with now, or the person that you could be releasing here. All right, let me get some additional cards on this world energy. What is this about for Cancer people? Ace of Winter, brand new beginning, and the Three of Spring. Okay, so around this world, again, this idea of kind of the end of something, making sure that all illusions are dispelled and that you're really clear, and you're coming to this whole sense of like, yes, you know, this is the pinnacle. And this is in the area of physical and sexual intimacy. It's really lovely energy here. We have this new information possibly coming in, a new idea about it, because whenever anything is at its peak, it goes into something new here, and that's really what we're looking at here for you, Cancer, in the area of physical and sexual intimacy. It could be new consciousness around it, or just like, you know, you've gotten to this point, and now you're going to go to a new place, and you're kind of igniting some passions, and you're beginning to maybe be more strategic. Maybe you've been enjoying a very physical relationship, and now you're beginning to create some consciousness around it. Like, wow, this is actually like we're actually really connected physically, we're connected emotionally, and now where do we go with this? You know, what is the next step for this? It's like maybe you're kind of thinking like that, like do we want to take it more seriously than I had even considered, you know, and then we have this idea of retreat, like do we want to move forward and go somewhere together? Could be an air sign involved here as well with that King of Winter. All right, let me get some cards on this retreat energy just to see if it's about spending time apart or maybe together. Let me just see. And then I'm going to close out your reading, Cancer. I mean, there's not a lot of court cards here, so really for you, I feel like it's about this energy of coming to a conclusion and then getting into something new here. It's really nice energy for you. But again, a little bit of that. Let me pause a bit and just make sure I'm where I want to be before I hit the gas. Okay, these two just came right out. So the retreat card is about the Four of Autumn and then kind of the sort of outcome-ish is, you know, if you want to look at it like this, is the Moon card. Major Arcana energy, which is about trusting your intuition as you move forward. And so I feel like with the Retreat card, it may be that you're kind of wanting to cling a little bit to the past, which is what that release is about, that release your ex is about, either an actual individual or an energy around that person, or how you were with that person. Maybe you've been bringing it into this new relationship, or I don't know why I say new relationship, I guess because we have the Dreamer here and the Ace, or the new cycle of your relationship. And if you're single, these are just energies that are present for you that you can tap into, looking at ways you were in the past, trusting your intuition as you go forward, not giving into fear and worry, because you're allowing things to reveal themselves as they're meant to. Like with the Moon energy, it's that lunar light. You can't see everything clearly yet. So that may be why you don't want to hit the gas, because you're just not quite sure yet. You're just not in a place. It's not the sun. It's not illuminating everything. It's in this kind of murkier energy. So that's okay. Just take your time. We're looking at a pretty short period of time, Cancer. So, and you're ruled by the Moon, you know? So trust your intuition here. It's going to be very, very powerfully attuned to the unseen energies, or the unseen in the manifest world. So anyway, I hope you find that. Oh, you know what? I'm going to get one more card for you. I'm going to get a card from the fairy deck for you before I close out your reading, Cancer. Let's just go with the fairy deck. No, you know, I want to go with the unicorns. I'm really feeling that today. Okay. For Cancer. Okay, water. Wow, well, you're Cancer, so this is fantastic. Drink more water and eat foods with water in them, such as fresh fruits and vegetables, which is a very important message, of course, in terms of your physical health and also spiritual health, because you are cleansing your body. You are moving energy out of your body with the water. Water is a powerful conduit of energy. But for you also, it goes for me with the Moon. You know, they're very... in tune with one another. When you consider the powerful pull of the Moon upon the tides, you know, creating that pull and that ability to recede, you know, as the Moon moves further away. And so this is important for you, Cancer, because, you know, you're ruled by the Moon. You know, you live in the water. And so it's going to be really important for you to tune into your intuition during this time period, especially around areas that have to do with love and romance, because not everything has been revealed yet, but trust your intuition no matter what the exterior world is showing you right now. If your intuition is telling you something different than what's being presented to you in the physical, I would say go with that right now in particular, just to make sure, because things are developing that haven't quite come to fruition yet. Because with the Ace energy, it is about the potential for something. And even the Dreamer, it's a brand new beginning, but you haven't really started the journey yet. You're just kind of on that leap of faith. So, okay, Cancer, I hope you find that helpful. I wish you much love as always, and I will see you on the next video or at your private reading. Till then.